What's up, guys? Welcome back to Flipping Finance with Greggy B. I apologize for the hiatus. I know it's been a little bit since I've made a finance video. But today I just want to go over a little bit about what's going on in the market. Just a very quick, brief take on all the Reddit activity, all the crazy activity, since there's been so much other input and other people's opinions about it. I don't really feel like I need to share mine too much, so I'm gonna just quickly go over that. We're gonna do a quick portfolio update so you guys can see how January went for me. And I'm gonna give you guys three tickers that I'm looking at this first week of February that I've been adding shares to and I believe have promising runs ahead. So let's jump right in. All right, I'm gonna try to do this Wall Street Bets Reddit thing in 20 seconds. So GameStop was worth a few bucks. Then it started to go up for a few legitimate reasons from the inside, you know, maybe from like 5 to 20 bucks. And some shorts kind of saw that and they're like, GameStop retailer, done. They didn't do their due diligence. Melvin, Citadel. So then they start shorting it. People realize that fundamentally it's actually worth what it popped to. And a quick war takes off, juices squoes and squeezed. And the retail investors won. I can just reiterate it and say it a million different ways, but if you're bought in anywhere before like the 10th pop, because it popped like 10 times before it actually popped over 100. If you bought in any of those times and then sold for any profit at 200, at 300, at 400, at 500, if you sold at those levels and just did not hold down to where it is now at $100, I actually just saw it's over 100 again. But if you just were able to take some profits and not be too greedy, if you were long, you won. If you were short, you lost. What we think we know as of now is the majority of the people that were short were hedge funds. The majority of people that were long were the little guy, retail investors. So we won. That was way more than 20 seconds. I'm really sorry. That's my opinion on the Wall Street Bet situation. Okay. And obviously the same thing happened with AMC costs, which cost headphones I kind of liked. I wanted to get in there low key, but never did. Never really got involved in these plays. They're too volatile for me. All right, that's it about that because I want to focus on other stuff. All right, there's just so many other things going on in the market that we can appreciate, although that situation is fascinating. Let's get into the portfolio and do an update. Here we go. All right, so we can see here that we have crossed over the 45K threshold, which is very exciting. If we look into the all-time here, we can see that is over 260%, which we're very grateful for. We have to pretty much attribute this to mostly Amazon, Apple, and Tesla, which make up over 60% of my portfolio. And that percentage will probably grow as those companies continue to grow. That's at least my take on it and the bet that I'm making. So with the other 40% of my portfolio, that's what I move around a little bit more, but I still try to have some investments that I don't do any selling within as well within these other positions. And then I also have 4 or 5% of crypto since it changes quickly. I only started with less than 1%. That's obviously grown throughout this winter. It's gone parabolic. So that's a little update on the portfolio. Really happy with how 2020 went. It was an amazing year for investing for me. And I'm hoping it's just the beginning. I've learned a lot and I want to apply this knowledge and continue to improve with my investing skills and, you know, get a community going around this channel because I know I've been slacking on that as well. Okay, let's get into the three tickers. I want you guys to keep on your watch list for this week and going forward. The first one is going to be Waitr Holdings, ticker WTHR. This is not DoorDash, this is not Grubhub, but it is a very, very small version of what those would be. It is quietly growing. It's still not in that many markets and it doesn't have any sort of the market share like the bigger delivery companies. But my brother was big on this stock. He knows a bit more than me, but I've done a little bit of due diligence and I know BlackRock just took a big investment, I think yesterday. And this company just seems stable even though it is a $4 stock. Okay, so it actually is considered a penny stock by some people who say penny stocks anything under $5 or anything under $10. But take a look at it. I think this one is just brewing for something big to come. All right, next stock is Rocket Companies, ticker RKT. This is the Rocket Mortgage platform. They offer home loans and other loans. This is a cool stock. I believe this stock is going places. It doesn't give you any real information. All right, let me gather myself. A little bit after this stock IPO'd, it jumped all the way over 30 bucks. There was a ton of hype. It has cooled off. It has consolidated a bunch. They have a lot of hype around the Super Bowl. They have like those Rocket Mortgage squares. So I just think leading into Sunday, we're sitting at Wednesday right now, I think there's going to be a little more talk around this company, which could lead to the stock price increasing. And if not, this is more of a long-term hold for me. I have 50 shares, just over 20 bucks here. And I have the weekly up here. We're right about 21.58. I remember the, I don't know if it was the CEO, but someone from Rocket Company spoke on CNBC a couple mornings ago, and it went from like 21 to 26 fast. And I think that is because there's a lot of short interest on this stock. So it kind of gets grouped into those with the high short interest, which isn't the worst place to be right now. It is a dangerous place to be. So if you're in stocks with high short interest, before that wasn't a good thing. Now it's still not a good thing, but it's kind of viewed as potentially a good thing if you're careful with it and you take advantage of some profits when your stocks do spike. So check out Rocket Companies, ticker RKT, Super Bowl Sunday. Let's go. All right, guys, last stock we have for today is Sundial Growers, ticker symbol SNDL. This is a healthcare slash cannabis play, which, to be honest with you, I do not have much conviction in, which means I don't really believe in it very much. Not bagging, I'm not trying to bag on it. If you're all about Sundial, I'm sorry. I got kind of caught up in this stock with the whole Reddit thing mistakenly. I was just looking for some penny stocks that I thought could double or go parabolic, and this one actually has more than doubled. I'm in there at like 65 cents or between 65 and 66 cents. And right now it's at $1.25. So just basically doubled my investment. So I should put a lot more than 300 shares in. But I only put in this small amount of money because I know there's a lot of hype around cannabis right now. My main cannabis play is Canopy Growth. And that's where I have 30 shares. And that's my more substantial position. And I'm in there early. So that's had a nice return for me. This was more of just a penny stock I was looking for just to throw some extra money at. And then this got caught up in the whole Wall Street Bets Reddit movement with some stocks that were highly shorted. This came in that category, which is why I still think maybe this has some room to run. And it's showing some nice daily and weekly movement, some good consolidation. Like I said, this can turn south at any moment. So I like Rocket Companies and Waitr a lot better. But check out Sundial, and it's a nice cannabis. It's a cannabis play if you're looking for a cheap one. And all right, so those are the tickers that I had. That's a little stock portfolio update and my take on the current situation with Reddit and Wall Street Bets. It's still early, right? I mean, you never know what could happen. GameStop could go back to 500. It could go to 1,000. Who knows? Do I think that's going to happen? Probably not. You know, maybe it'll pop. It'll spike up a few times, maybe into the 200s, maybe even higher. But I think as quickly as it goes up, it most likely will come down. That's typically how these things go with very volatile situations. But good luck, you know, best of luck to everyone out there in these plays, and take some profits when you get them. Take them off the table, reallocate the capital, move it around to other plays. And if you're constantly selling at least some in the green and moving it to somewhere else and then waiting, being patient, selling that in the green, that's how you can build wealth over time and keep that portfolio looking nice. So that's Flipping Finance with Greggy B for today. We're going to be back with more consistent videos on the regular. Let me know what you guys want to see, any tickers you guys want me to talk about. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace and love.